storyboarding, and I guess I'm mostly used as a set designer, which is great. And then I had the opportunity to do character designs. I've been in the industry for about 22 years. I started in TV animation with Disney TV, and then I jumped over to Disney Toons, where I worked on a lot of sequels like Tinkerbell. And then I jumped over to Imagi Studios, did Astro Boy. And around 2009, I went to Pixar, and I worked on Cars 2, Monsters University, Inside Out, and Coco. And Coco, I did a little bit of character design. I still do storyboarding. I go back and forth, depending on the need. You're a director with a pencil. You're kind of like scoping out the scene. You're pretty much the cameraman. You're the set designer because you're kind of suggesting how the set is based on what you're telling. So you're wearing a lot of hats. You're just trying to hit emotional cues. Mm-hmm. You're trying to get people to feel. Yeah, you want people to care. It's not easy. It's sometimes it's frustrating and sometimes it's lonely, but the payoff is wonderful. Okay, tip number one for storyboarding is, I would say, know your characters. Get to know the characters as far as like, who are they? What do they do? What do they want? Get to know their character profile. The reason is you can better get an idea of their situation, what they're gonna think about, how they're gonna respond to things. This way, it kind of opens up more like possibilities in your storyboarding. Tip number two, a lot of times what you want to do is go beyond the script. Sometimes you want to see if you can contribute things that have the essence of the story, but if you can find a better solution, a stronger solution, a better way to say what you want to, maybe visually, either moving the camera around or more performance, that's what you want to strive for. The script is there, you just want to keep the essence of the story, but if there's always a way to tell it better, that's what you want to do. Tip number three is educate yourself. A lot of times storyboard artists, they don't actually come from film school, they come from art school and they kind of make their way into storyboarding. I would say start thinking yourself as a film student, a film scholar. That doesn't mean going to film school, it just means start embedding yourself with film language. Every day, maybe look at three scenes of movies. Look at the scene, look at how it begins, look at how it ends, and just see what the choices were that the director made. Sometimes the character comes in, sometimes he's reacting to something, there's other players, they react. There's a bit of information there that the director wants the viewer to see. That's why it's in the movie. All these little scenes are mini movies within the big movie. So if you study the scene, sometimes things are subtle, sometimes they're big, but they're great lessons as far as choices of what they made. Choices in composition, camera, staging, lighting, performance. All of these things help kind of deliver what's important in that scene. Tip number four, I would recommend, especially for young storyboard artists, start looking at movies that are a little older than you. Look at movies before CGI, which would mean look at movies before like the mid-1980s. The reason is a lot of those filmmakers, they didn't rely on CGI to gratuitously show maybe the monster or certain characters or special effects. What they did was they had to show things economically. So there was a lot of suspense. A good movie to recommend would be the first Alien movie by Ridley Scott. If you look at that movie, it's like a suspense horror movie, but you don't see the alien until the last 10 minutes of the movie.
This is completely enclosed, and it's full of leathery objects like eggs or something.
So what it is, it's a lot of buildup, it's a lot of suspense, it's a lot of, what was that? You know, dark shadows, things moving, a lot of reaction cuts, a lot of quick pacing until you get to the, and so forth. There's a lot of that, and it's beautifully done. That is great economic storytelling, and that's just well planned, and it's just a great way to like educate yourself as far as what you can do without actually showing stuff. It's a great way of storytelling. Jaws, the first one, great movie. Any Steven Spielberg movie is always good. He's got great composition, great setups. He does great large shots, and then he cuts close with a close-up of the character, and then he pans out, and then you see the reaction, and then you kind of turn around and you see what he's reacting to. If you turn the sound off, you're focusing on the performance, the visuals, and that way you can kind of see how things are reacting, and then these are your cues, and this really helps you understand, you know, what's happening, reaction, and then outcome. Number five for storyboarding, just don't be afraid. A lot of people are hung up on, they don't want to make mistakes. Mistakes are your friend. They're there because they help you understand things. You know, you have to mess it up so you can build it up, okay? That's how you learn. Don't be scared to make marks, and if they don't make sense, that's okay. Look at your mess, your quote mess, and then work it up. A lot of this stuff is problem solving. You don't do it in the first pass, you don't do it in the second pass. Storyboarding, there's a quote that our artists at Pixar have, it's reboarding. And that's what it is. You do this over and over again. So just welcome that, embrace it. And it's like you're thinking with a pencil. So free yourself and learn to draw without fear and draw fearlessly and just go for it.